welcome to Cafe Inoma and welcome to our reaction to Radiohead. And we are going to react to the song Street Spirit. This is our first time single take honest reaction to Street Spirit of Radiohead. Let's get started.
Thank you for your love, support, patience and tolerance in helping us make these uncut, unscripted, impromptu reaction videos. We would never hear about such songs if it wasn't for you. Radiohead's Street Spirit. Thanks to your patronage, your views, your love. Let's get started.
Touching me, oh, this thing's a two-position. Oh, this thing's a one-day swallow hole.
Thank you.
That's not the way the song ended.
No, I think that is just...
Oh, this was deep. This was intense. This was prolific. Prolific. Prolific songwriting, prolific presentation by Radiohead. What a voice, and how well he uses it with that fade out again line. Oh, the lines say it all, the helplessness of it all, you know, staring. It's literally like you're staring at failure, staring at the end, staring at death, staring at everything that signifies the end. And it's like no matter how hard you try, you know you're not going to win at the end of the day. It's kind of like, you know, you're against a demonic creature at times. You know, even though it's not mentioned in the lines, you kind of get the sense he's talking about being against some demonic creature, you know, some Godzilla-like character. And because of that, he's just fading out again. He's just helpless. He knows it's all useless, pointless at the end of the day. But at the same time, he says, immerse your soul into love. You know, earlier there was a line, stand in a circle kind of thing. You know, he's basically saying, love each other. You know, no matter what, love each other. That's what will help us through these times. It will help us through everything and will help beautify our daily lives, daily life. What are your thoughts, Kirti? Any specific message you got out of it? What did you like in the music, the voice, anything at all?
I like everything about this song. This is genius. This is genius. This is something. Apart from genius, I don't get any word right now in my mind to describe this. The talent, the amount of talent we just heard. It was like his voice was like a catalyst for the instruments that were playing, the guitar and the music. It was all, you know, music was providing the background, and when he would sing, it would create that reaction, the chemical kind of reaction while listening. So this was a different experience. It has, it was working on different levels while you're listening to it as a song. I like that guitar work, the way it goes throughout the song, and then that hauntingly amazing vocals that he puts.
This is not the first time I've heard a vocalist try singing something like that.
Right.
You know, many other vocalists in the last 3.5 years on YouTube, as well as, of course, all our lives, we've heard music. So it's nothing new that someone tries to present something like that.
Mm-hmm.
But the way he does it is different from most others.
It is the timing, it is the tone, it is, I think, everything.
The way he builds it up to that fade out again line is just captivating. It's you can't even really compare it with someone else. That is, this vocalist is in a league of his own. Let's put it that way. He's in a league of his own, a class apart. The way he sings it, the timing, everything, it just seems to fit in perfectly. Nothing seems out of sync, even, of course, the other band members. Nothing seems untimely. Nothing seems, oh, this is weird. Nothing seems that way. It's just smooth. It's just smooth as silk. And that's the effect it has on the listener too, like me, or the first time listener to this song. Perfect timing, perfect presentation.
Yeah, for me, the music was all in the way it is actually created as a song. The lyrics are good, but any other band, any other musician, would they have done the same thing with the similar lyrics? I doubt.
Yeah.
Would it sound the
same
thing?
That's exactly my point.
Wouldn't. It wouldn't. Most probably it wouldn't. It wouldn't be this striking. It wouldn't be this kind of experience.
That's what both of us actually now. And I always say that, you know, it just doesn't sound right.
Hmm.
We realize that this isn't how it's supposed to sound. The words are right. You know, most of the times the words are right. We know what the words mean. But the way it is presented, the way it is sung, the way it is played, the instrument, it just doesn't sound right. This is perfection.
This is
chemistry at its best.
Yeah.
You know, nothing can go wrong. In chemistry, specifically when you're dealing with volatile chemicals, explosive chemicals, not a single thing can go wrong, whether in weight, timing of adding it to each other, or anything else. the apparatus is used, the apparatus used rather, nothing can go wrong. One tiny microscopic mishap and you're probably dead. In music, these guys possibly get it. Radiohead.
Yeah.
That aspect of chemistry, they get it. I've heard that in U2 almost every single time.
Yeah, this the chemistry that I'm talking about,
I hear it in almost every single U2 song I've heard so far. That chemistry. It's a different thing whether I connect with the lyrics, I understand them. It's a different thing whether I like the music or not. The chemistry is what I'm talking about. And here it was overflowing with it.
Midway through the song, I was thinking, what does it sound like? What does it sound like? Is it Europe or something? I said, no, it's only U2 that I can remember. Europe, we have reacted to very few songs. They are different. But this was amazing. This was on another level altogether.
Yeah. And it starts off with him like kind of like walking on the street with the houses. He's feeling the blue colors of the roofs maybe. Maybe he's in Greece or something. He's feeling it like it's going to swallow him by the end of it. That's how I felt. It's like some kind of demonic creature he's describing.
I don't know about demonic creature or not, but it definitely connects with me. The way I connect with it is as simple as Buddha's journey or something like that.
Okay, could you explain that a bit for all of us? Elaborate on it.
It's all about, you know, him seeing so much misery and so many, things that are happening. He can see it, he can feel it, he can actually experience looking at it. He can get petrified by what he's seeing.
Exactly.
The egg and the bird and everything.
That's a good way to look at it.
So, I don't like talking about religious figures all the time, but they have given so much to the world and there is so much base that they have already laid out for the world that we can't really live in denial that they don't exist or they don't matter or I don't believe in religion. It's not about believing in religion or not, but the teachings, the learnings and all that wealth of knowledge that has been left behind. Who do we credit? Just ourselves? Just rob it and say, I did that? No, I wouldn't do that. So, I try to avoid taking those references, but at times like these, it becomes inevitable for me to just ignore that aspect.
Well, you hit the nail on the head, and possibly a Buddha-like character or
experience
inspired him to write, or the writers to think on these lines, and they feel the same.
So, seeing life with your bare eyes the way it is, not trying to sugarcoat things, not trying to justify things why they are happening, just seeing it as it is and how it impacts you, and then what is the solution? Just immerse yourself in love, because there is no other way you're going to get out of this cycle. Either you face it or you will chicken out and take your life. So there are only two ways of doing it. So he's choosing to actually face it and live more bravely.
Beautiful. Thank you for these requests. We would not hear songs like this if it wasn't for you guys. So keep them coming. We're here to entertain you. We're here to share our honest, sincere, uncut, impromptu review with you. And whether you like it or don't like it, that's not the point. The point is we are here for a purpose, to listen to great music along with you, as well as at the same time, share our honest opinion on it. And that's what we've done here. We hope it was entertaining and useful maybe. We certainly found the song entertaining and useful too.
Useful.
That's it for this
one. Heartwarming.